What's going on, guys? Ryan O'Toole back here again, giving you guys another video. Today I thought about doing something a little different. If you didn't check out my channel update, which I just uploaded, I said that I would be doing a new type of video that I've never done before, and that is doing a bunch of quick movie reviews. I'm going to be reviewing the movies that I did see this year, but I didn't get a chance to do a review for it on my channel. Let me know down below in the comment section your thoughts and opinions on these movies. What grades would you give them? And let's have a great discussion. Gaudi is a crime film that came out this year, directed by Kevin Connolly, starring John Travolta as John Gaudi, which I just watched today to prepare for this video. And oh my God, this movie is so terrible. I can't even describe this movie. Like, what the hell is it? Is it a biopic about John Gaudi? It's him. The movie talking about his whole entire life. The movie's like a pinball machine. It jumps through different timelines so completely fast. I was so bored throughout this whole entire movie and so confused. One of the worst crime films I've ever seen. John Travolta as John Gaudi is absolutely awful in this film. He's a great actor, but here he's so stone cold, so one note, you don't give a shit about him at all. I didn't. I was bored throughout this whole entire movie. They were just given an awful script. This whole entire movie is trash, garbage, piss pile. One of the worst films I've seen this year. It is absolutely horrendous. So on my rating scale, I'm going to give Gaudi, of course, a 0 out of 5 stars. We're getting the bad movies out of the way. The next bad movie that I did see most recently is Robin Hood. Otto Badhurst, the director of this film, should be completely ashamed because this movie is laughably atrocious. It's a complete joke. The whole movie is ridiculous. The action sequences are terribly shot. The visual effects look atrocious, and the performances are so wooden. Taron Egerton, stay in Kingsman, bro, because you're terrible in this film. The script is bad. Jamie Foxx as Little John is also bad. And Marion in this film, wow, super offensive towards women. And Ben Mendelsohn as the Sheriff of Nottingham, extremely over the top. We're gonna get my money back, and I'm going to get Robin Hood. Oh my God, this movie is so laughably awful. Save your money to see another great film like Aquaman coming up, because this movie's absolutely garbage, and I can totally see why it flopped heavily in the box office. Just like Gaudi, I'm going to give Robin Hood 2018 a 0 out of 5 stars. Uncle Drew, I just watched this movie today, and I'm a big NBA fan. I love basketball. I love the Boston Celtics and Kyrie Irving as Uncle Drew. It was exactly what I was expecting it to be. It was a lot of fun, but it's not a great movie at all. All the actors in this movie are just having a total blast with their roles. Kyrie Irving, especially, the point guard of the Celtics, plays Uncle Drew. And Kyrie in this film, he's funny. And you have Lorel Howery as the main character in this movie. Lorel Howery, excuse me, from Get Out. He was funny. I really liked his character, and he was the most relatable character out of all of them. Tiffany Haddish plays his ex-girlfriend, and she's freaking hilarious. Nick Kroll was really over the top. I would say my issues with Uncle Drew just lie with the story. Some parts of the story were completely unnecessary. Like, there's this rivalry and heated exchange with Kyrie and Shaq in this movie. That was just, tried to build some tension, but you didn't need to focus on it too much. And there's some unnecessary scenes, like there's a lawn dance sequence that happens. That, alright, you could have cut that out of the movie. It's a complete blast if you're a basketball fan, so check it out if you love basketball. On my rating scale, I'm going to give Uncle Drew a 3 out of 5 stars. Bad Times at the El Royale, directed by Drew Goddard. This has an all-star cast involved. Jeff Bridges, Chris Hemsworth, Dakota Johnson, John Hamm. Oh my God, so many A-list stars in this movie that it feels like a straight Quentin Tarantino film, which everybody has talked about. So Bad Times at the El Royale, I saw this in theaters with First Man, and I really enjoyed a lot of aspects of this film. but I was kind of a little let down with it. I would say the whole movie visually looks stunning. The cinematography, the overall setting of the El Royale is really great. I really love how this hotel is designed, like having a split line between California and Nevada, I believe. But yeah, that was a really cool aspect. All the performances are so good in this film. Jeff Bridges was one of my favorites. John Hamm was also terrific. And Dakota Johnson from 50 Shades Trilogy is also not that bad. The movie does have a twist at the end that really, I felt it was a little lackluster. And you have Chris Hemsworth as this awesome villain role, this Buffalo Bill impersonator. The final act just got a little bit choppy. The first act was slow. It feels like a very rip-off Tarantino film that I wish had a lot more originality to it. In the end, Bad Times at the El Royale has fantastic performances. Just not one of my favorites, but still not a bad film. I'm going to give Bad Times at the El Royale a 3.5 out of 5 stars. Excuse me, but I'm sorry to bother you. Sorry to bother you. This was one of the highly praised films that came out this year really early on. I didn't see it in theaters. It was playing nowhere near me. And this movie is just a really crazy film. Boots Riley did a really interesting job directing it. The performances are great. Lakeith Stanfield was terrific. And Danny Glover probably was my favorite just because of how great his character is. He gives a really funny line in this movie about using your white voice and saying, "I'm getting too old for this shit." Just gives the iconic Danny Glover line. The movie does have a very interesting storyline talking about racial stereotypes today with black people using their white voices in work today, and I found those parts of this movie very interesting. I wanted it to focus on that a lot, but then the movie just kept going on and talking about this one specific subplot that I did not like. It happens in the final act. I won't spoil it for those who haven't seen it. The final act of this movie is garbage. There's this one thing that happens that just really pissed me off, but other than that, I wanted to love this movie more than I did. I found Sorry to Bother You extremely overrated. It does have some great racial storylines involved that does have some good messages. Constant rewatches, I might like it more, but other than the performances, this movie's just okay. I'm gonna give Sorry to Bother You a 3 out of 5 stars. Please won't you be my neighbor. Won't You Be My Neighbor, the Fred Rogers documentary that came out, all about Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood. I absolutely love this documentary. I thought it was fantastic. Just learning a lot of things about Mr. Rogers, not knowing anything about his personal life and all about the show and the creation of Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood. All the struggles that Fred Rogers had to do putting this show together, dealing with racism and all that. But his love for children, just seeing the perspectives of all the different actors who were involved with Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood. There's a really important scene in here about a racial thing that happened back in the day involving black people in pools. It really is fantastic writing. This documentary is fantastic. I could definitely see it winning Best Documentary Feature at the Oscars. So glad I finally watched this film. It's so great. It's not perfect. It does have some slow moments to it, and it's not perfect. Rewatchability is not high, but still, it's fantastic. I'm going to give Won't You Be My Neighbor a 4.5 out of 5 stars. Revenge. I loved Revenge. If you guys have never seen this movie, it's a really great revenge movie. Talking about this girl out in the middle of the desert, and these three guys rape her to death and leave her out for dead, and she comes back with a vengeance and kills all of those guys responsible for leaving her there. It is such a riveting film from start to finish that it had me on the edge of my seat. The direction was fantastic, and the action sequences are so brutal and in your face that they're so damn bloody. This is the bloodiest film I've seen this year, hands down. There's no character development. The bad guys really don't get fleshed out. And the girl, you're 100% on the girl's side throughout this whole entire film. It makes you care about what's going on and you want to see her succeed and get out and survive. This is a survival movie mixed with a revenge movie, and I freaking love those types of films. This is one of the more underrated films this year. If you haven't seen Revenge, it's on Blu-ray or on demand. Go check it out. It's great. And I'm going to give Revenge a 4.5 out of 5 stars, just based on the rewatchability factor. Oh man, I've been waiting to talk about this one. Black Klansman, directed by Spike Lee, starring John David Washington and Adam Driver. This is one of my favorite films this year. I loved Black Klansman. This is one of the best screenplays of this whole entire year. It's based on a true story. John David Washington as this officer Ron Stallworth, who infiltrates the KKK, talking on the phone with David Duke and Adam Driver, talking with the KKK in person. It's a mind-blowing, unrealistic true story that I absolutely love. Spike Lee gives one of his best directed films. I personally believe this is his best film. John David Washington gives one of the best performances this year. He should be Oscar worthy. Adam Driver is fantastic as well. The movie goes in directions I didn't expect and has a lot of powerful messages in it. And I find this to be a perfect film. If you have not seen Black Klansman, please watch it. It's so damn good. Black Klansman, of course, gets a 5 out of 5 stars. Crazy Rich Asians. This was another film I was late to the party with back in the time, and I didn't get a chance to review it, and I liked Crazy Rich Asians. I thought it was a really well-made film, a great romantic comedy film that is kind of like The Big Sick from last year, with all the cultural differences in this whole entire film. It's based on the novel Constance Wu and Henry Golden. I really believed in their relationship. They were fantastic with each other. Awkwafina might have been the show stealer for me. I thought she was hilarious in Ocean's 8, and in here she's funny as well. But Michelle Yeoh might be my favorite performance in this whole entire film. Just the constant tension with her and Constance Wu and the cultural differences is just terrific. Like, it goes in directions I didn't expect it. It does have some dull moments to it. It does have some cliche romantic comedy storylines in it. But still, I thought the direction was solid, and it's a really feel-good film. It's an important film, because this movie did well in the box office, and I hope they do more films like this. I'm going to give Crazy Rich Asians a 4 out of 5 stars. And the final film I'm going to be reviewing is one of my favorite films this year, top 5 for sure after rewatch. That is Searchin'. I got to give props to the director. Please forgive me if I butcher this person's name, Anish Chaganti. He did a fantastic job directing this film. This film was suspenseful from start to finish. I was on the edge of my seat even rewatching it, even I knew what happens in the film. This film is terrific. It is one of the best thrillers and one of the best, possibly the best found footage film ever made. I'm not even joking. John Cho's performance should be talked about more for Oscar contention, but one of the best performances this year. Even the detective and the family members were also great. The time lapses are extremely good. The twists are extremely unpredictable. The story kept me on the edge of my seat and engaged throughout the whole entire film. And it's a rewatchable thriller. This thriller is so good. It's the best thriller I've seen since Gone Girl. My God, it might be even better than Gone Girl, if I'm being completely honest. Searchin' is a terrific concept and one of the best films this year. Go see Searchin' right now. This film gets a 5 out of 5 stars. One of the best films this year. Man, there was a lot of movies I talked about, but still, it's great to talk about them regardless. If you guys have seen any of these films, please leave me your thoughts and opinions down below. Let's have a great discussion. Thank you guys, as always, for watching this video. And if you guys liked it, give it a thumbs up. And if you're new to the channel, be sure to subscribe today for more content. All my social media links are in the description down below. Click that notification bell on your way out, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye!